Let's go get the VTEC head.
Get that off first.
What is this? Here, hold on. Okay, it's done. That's how it works, isn't it?
No.
What do you mean?
No.
I want 300 horsepower, so I threw that at it. You telling me it's not going to work that way?
No.
Okay, guys, welcome back.
I didn't know what you want to call us anymore. Are we YouTubers? We're not even that.
We're back. That's what we are.
So, a lot has changed in the BS for Boost garage. Boy, oh boy. We've sold 5 cars. We sold a lot, but we haven't sold this. If you're not familiar, this is our 1999 Civic Ute. We built it out of a 4-door. Let me show you, it's dirty.
It's extremely dirty. I don't know if it even does it. Oh yeah, you can see it when I get up close. Get far away, it's so-so. The shine still looks good. Poor thing's been sitting in the garage for a year, I think, now. I think it was almost a little over a year ago we started this project. Kind of crazy to think.
Yeah, more than that. It's been 2 years now.
No.
Yeah.
No.
We've had 2 winters now. This is our 3rd winter on this car.
Shut your beeping mouth. All right. So, we're on the home stretch. COVID hit. And, well, we just push it off to the side because there's no car shows. And now we want to get it done. So, we are going to do the head gasket on it today, or this video. We're going to change it, put the VTEC head on it. For anyone that isn't familiar, let's check this out. We have a Turbo D Series with a lot of dust.
And cobwebs.
Boop. Boop. And start of a wire tuck and everything else.
What we're going to do is we're going to get this head off. We are going to get our VTEC head on. New water pump, time belt, head gasket. We have head studs for this. We're not going for a lot of power, but we're going for reliable power. I still want like 220. Yeah. So we have an Edelbrock turbo kit. It's a Garrett T28 with 550cc injectors. We have a AM340. I think we went overboard on the fuel pump because I didn't want to do it more than once. It's a 340. And things like that. So we have Honda data for this as well. And if you haven't recognized it, this is our Civic Ute. So we have to do a few more things on it, but for the most part, it's done.
So last time we tried to do this, we couldn't get, that's pretty sad that we have brand new brakes on it and look at them. We couldn't get the crank pulley off. So what we're going to end up having to do is getting the heat on this because it's not going to go. We know it's not going to go. We are taking the K-frame out of this. A, we're going to go manual steering. And B, we want to power coat it as well. When he's looking for the right size bolt, here is the dirty, dirty, filthy interior. We're going to get it finished off. Get the glass changed, get the carpet back in, do our carbon fiber headliner.
We did order carbon fiber. I should probably take it in the house where it's a little warmer. We're doing our upper rails here in carbon fiber. And we are going to do our full lip kit in carbon fiber because I like to party. I kind of want to do the fenders. If I do the fenders, I'm not going to lie, they're going to be overlaid. I'm not going to make a mold right now. But even overlaid, I think they'd look really, really good. So leave a comment down below.
What?
Exactly. Leave a comment down below. Do you want to see purple carbon fiber fenders to match the carbon fiber lip kit?
You're going to need heat because we couldn't get it last time with that.
We never used this. We used an air impacted, didn't
no,
we?
No, you bored your buddies.
No, we didn't.
We only used air.
Bingo!
Alright, so I guess we're doing a head gasket.
Yep.
Yay! We should put unfit for this.
No.
We're going to get harassed as it is. Okay, I'll hold this up. I don't know what we're going to do with this hood. Maybe I should get off my butt and order the proper stuff so this hood will hold itself up. So basically, you just got to undo this one motor mount. It looks like there's tons of room there.
Yeah, once you undo the motor mount, pull it out, pull the crank pulley off. And it allows you to take the cotton cover off and water pump and everything else.
The valve cover is just sitting there so that can pop off.
Yep.
Turbo is just a couple studs just to make it look nice. Means we can actually start buttoning things up for good?
Maybe.
No way.
Good thing is we can finally finish up this project, get it done, and then start showing you guys cool stuff in this project. I would love to haul Christmas tree this year. Ain't gonna happen.
That's wonderful thing.
Yeah, that ain't gonna happen.
You might get the skeleton on the Christmas tree this year. I just plan on going chopping down in the woods.
Who really needs to buy hood prop rods for like 150 bucks American when I can just take a boomstick to the car shows? No. Okay, so we have the crank pulley off. He is undoing the motor mount, as you will see as we speak. And then, okay, so we got it off. Now it's time to get the timing belt off. And then we can, we're going to take the intake manifold off, which is only going to be a couple bolts holding on anyways. This is the good thing, is now we can start reassembling things for good. So like the head, the turbo always just sat there because it was just sitting there for looks. Now we can actually bolt everything down, get the intercooler. Oh my God, we can do intercooler, the piping. That's not that old at all. Guess what though? We still need to do a V-tech head.
Uh-huh.
And we have a new timing belt.
Uh-huh.
Water pump, head gasket, oil pan,
yep.
Oil pan gasket. We got everything.
Might as well do it right the first time instead of doing it half.
Oh my God, look at how much oil is still in that head.
It doesn't drain back very well.
How the hell? Let's get some JB Weld and add some more lobe to it.
No!
Don't get it on paint. You don't want to do a custom grind? That's what they do. They just take some JB Weld over top of it.
Yeah, I don't think it's quite how they do it. What do you guys think? A little bit of JB Weld, a little bit of sanding. That's how you get the lobe. Each valve would be different.
I don't know if you guys can even see that. Look, yeah, you can. Look at the oil in it.
What?
The oil in the cavities.
Yep.
Is that normal?
Yeah. It's just the head design, because you gotta think the only thing underneath that is the cylinder, so it's not gonna leak into the cylinders.
No wonder why Honda's burning so much oil. What is this? Here, hold on. Okay, it's done. That's how it works, isn't it?
No.
What do you mean?
No.
I want 300 horsepower, so I threw that at it. You telling me it's not going to work that way?
No.
I don't want 300 horsepower either. I want 220 horsepower. Pow. Watch the fucking piston snap. Boy, would I be mad.
Well, Viterra pistons early.
Yeah, then I'd go bigger turbo. Then what? Then we got us off a big mess. Yeah, but if I'm doing the Viterra...
really quick spool.
If I'm doing the bottom end, I'd want like 450.
No.
Yeah.
No.
I want, yeah.
That is so useless in this thing.
Jeff, look at me for a second. We're putting an SXE 366 on the NYG.
That's a race car.
No, it's not. We're going for like 550 in a freaking front wheel drive neon.
It's a Mexico racer. What are you talking about?
Useless.
It'll be fun.
What is this?
A show car.
This is a parts rig.
Yeah, this is a runaround car. When do you need 400 horsepower in a runaround car?
You're telling me my Camaro has too much power?
That's not a runaround car.
Yes, it is.
That's a backup car.
Well then, you just have answers for everything.
So, the joys of having this car for I don't know how many years. Jeff says three, I say one. I don't freaking know. But... we ordered a brand new head gasket, time belt, water pump, tensioner, the whole kit and caboodle with a new oil pan and oil pan gasket. We found the oil pan. We found the oil pan gasket. We found the tensioner.
We found the water pump gasket.
Yeah, gasket, but we haven't found nothing else. So we're now on hold until the new stuff comes in off Rock Auto. We had to buy all the gate stuff. So that won't be here till next week. But we also did buy hood struts, finally. So the hood can be proper. I almost bought a clear hood.
Yeah.
I really want that clear hood. And
What else did we get? The vent, the AN10 for the back of the block for the catch can.
Yeah.
And an aluminum rad and all new rad hoses. So that's going to put that here. We do have our VTEC head sitting over there in the bag, which came from the machine shop that way. So this is going to be pretty well set off to the side until it comes in. A week later, we have our head gasket, water pump, timing belt. All that stuff has come in. And we have our hood strut kits from Japan. Lower that down. So we're gonna get that installed first, see where it puts us. Actually, it showed up faster than the head gasket from Rock Auto.
Which is weird.
It really is. All right, so we have this wonderful kit. Just gonna start getting the one side on. Let's see how this works. This should have been done long ago. Okay, first things first, let's see if it clears the hood.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Should. Yeah, it's inside the edge of it.
Man, yeah, it is. It just has me worried.
Yeah.
Okay, so the center washer there. The engine bay looks awfully nice right now. As you guys can see how dirty it is. Just a washer.
Just a flat washer.
Yeah, okay. Just a small washer. Really? They're going to give me a polished washer? Who does that? See if you can use the purple washer.
No, it won't because it's tapered in. This isn't. That's just a...
Try it. Just see what happens.
It won't work.
Well, I don't like the polished washer.
Then it will also be much too short. Like,
yeah.
I won't be able to tighten up, except for by hand is the only problem. I can't get a wrench on it.
Don't even use a washer. Oh, you have to use a washer. Put it in. We'll have to power coat them at a later date or get black ones.
Do something, yeah.
I ain't putting polished on there.
It looks silly.
Who does that?
Cheap kit, and a lot of cars aren't like...
Cheap, it was $100 and some odd American. Merca.
Merca.
That's like 500 Canadian. That is not cheap. Watch the fender. You have a thing with fenders. And anyone that doesn't know what we're talking about, the SRT swap NYG that you have not seen yet, Jeff dented the fender.
I didn't, the battery did.
That was you. You had the battery in your hand.
I didn't know it was the battery.
All right, so let's get the one strut on. We're moving up in the world. What?
Fancy.
Oh, I didn't want to wait for Jeff, so I clipped this one on when he was having technical difficulties.
Because I told you it didn't need to be.
There. Somewhat. Jeff,
what?
You rub it with your finger, it gets off. Yay! For anyone that's looking for it, we bought that, ST. Suki
like
Tech.
It was like the first one to show up, actually.
Yeah. I will, I can post it online, the link I bought. Literally 2 days shipping to Canada. Three days shipping. It was crazy, actually.
I was quite surprised at that.
So now it's head gasket time. You need to clean that head. There was a razor blade. I like to cut things. Nee, 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 nee.
Oh, I should realize we didn't get a freaking keyway.
That strut bar might look alright.
I did some Amazon shopping and I bought a rear strut bar, DCCS2 to match the back. So
you see it does go up a little bit. If I don't like it, I have it sold to Chris. So
yeah.
That's the only reason why I bought it. Chris, if it was $100. That one was 110. And now on Amazon, they're like 280.
Jeez.
So, America.
America.
Don't lose all the stuff. You're losing stuff.
I'm trying.
You're losing stuff.
No, I'm trying to get it out.
Ain't that hard to get out. Man, what are you doing? I was going to say, it's literally straight from the machine shop a year ago. Does it say the date? No. Plain head. What's a plain head? It says plain head. What's a plain head? There you go. Head on.
Done.
Now the wonderful thing. So do we just... There you go.
Done.
Turbo time. Where's turbo?
Down there.
I ain't throwing that.